Hi, Bridget. Congratulations on your retirement. I sure do wish I could be there for the party, but in my absence, I wanted to send a short video thanking you for the great results you drove at Target and also for taking so much time to teach me about our systems. The first thing you taught me was that the OTL equal the on-hand plus the on-order, or that the order to level equals the safety stock weeks of supply or the pres min, whichever is greater, plus the forecast times the lead time plus review time over two. Bridget, you also taught me that you just never, ever don't pass basics. In fact, you taught me that if the maintenance was properly applied by the business analyst and by the replenishment experts, that it's easy to automatically approve 100% of the basics every week. Didn't you and I have fun getting everybody to do just that? Bridget, you also taught me that the system doesn't make random mistakes. And if we were out of stock or overstock, you taught me that if I asked enough questions, that generally I would find there might have been a small vendor or team member issue. Bridget, thanks for all that you taught me. You gave me just enough knowledge to be a little dangerous and to be a big pain in the butt for my team. You drove great results while you were at Target, Bridget, and you deserve a great retirement. Congratulations, and just one little thing, you don't really have to turn this in. Thanks, Bridget.
Hello, Bridget. Congratulations on your retirement. I was asked to record a video about what I learned from you. The answer is simple. I learned to appreciate the many wonders of 1970s disco music. And I'd like to express my appreciation through song. Bridget, there's no need to feel down. I said, Bridget, pick yourself off the ground. I said, Bridget, just because your in-stocks are red, there's no need to be unhappy. Bridget, there's a system you can use. I said, Bridget, trust air and you just can't lose. You can approve your basics in full, and I'm sure you'll find many ways to have a good time. It's fun to use in forum 6.12. It's fun to use in forum 6.12. Inform has lots of parameters for you to enjoy. You can forecast demand in socks or toys. It's fun to use in forum 6.12. It's fun to use in forum 6.12.
Hey, Bridget, Debbie Reynolds here. LT, WOS, RT, OTL, ETA, AWS, Prez Min, and remember our first replenishment system, ARP or ARP? Well, ARP will have a whole new meaning for you now, Bridget. Bridget, what can I say about you? Pretty simple, really. You understood the word help. You were so knowledgeable, patient, and instructive. You totally understand Target's replenishment systems because, of course, you were instrumental in developing them. And you stayed cool and calm, mostly, when every time I called you, it was an HBA emergency. You were always there for me and the team, and I bet Jeff and Carrie are hyperventilating as they wish you goodbye. Happy retirement, Bridget. You made a real difference for Target.
Bridget Evans, in preparation for your retirement, we need to rethink the OTL formula in a drastic way. You and I know the OTL formula really well, but we're going to change it, okay? Now, the OTL formula originally, you know as well as I do, a lead time worth of forecasted sales, okay? But in retirement, that's not going to work, okay? We're going to take out that lead time of forecasted sales, and then for you, we're going to actually add a lifetime of achievement, because that's what you've done here at Target, okay? Now, to that, in the OTL formula, we would add a reorder frequency of forecasted sales, but that's not going to work in retirement either. So instead, we're going to say RT is response time. And for you, whenever I worked with you on a project or anybody else, the response time was immediate. So we have a lifetime of achievement, we add in response time, which was immediate, and then normally it'd be present or safety stock. That certainly doesn't work in retirement. So instead, we add in the qualities that people remember and appreciate about you the most, that you were dedicated, and that you cared deeply about the people around you, both people reporting to you and the people around you. So you have a lifetime of achievement, response time was immediate, dedicated and caring, and that is our new OTL formula, okay? But OTL stands for something different when I think about you. It stands for the optimal target leader. That's the new OTL formula. Bridget, congratulations on your retirement. I'll see you on the cross-country ski trail and on the biking trail. This will not be the last time we talk, but I just wanted to say big congratulations on your retirement.
Oh, hello there. Just doing some light reading. Really great read anytime you get a chance. Anyway, though, now that you're here, just wanted to say thanks for everything. Thank you for being a mentor as I've come into ops. Thank you for all your help with all the system questions I've had and the extensive knowledge transfer that's had to happen for RapidRep. I know I couldn't have done it without you. One thing I'm definitely going to miss, though, is being able to tell people that Bridget said so, and nobody questions that. So that'll be something I'll miss, and I'll miss our biweekly touch bases. I've learned a lot, and thank you for all your help.
Bridget, congratulations on an amazing, amazing career at Target. Just think of all the people you've met, what you've learned, how many people you've taught about OTLs and the importance of best methods. Most importantly, Bridget, the impact that you've had on the team, on our business, and on the Target brand in total. You really have quite a legacy here at Target, and I hope you're able to take this time and really enjoy yourself, look back upon your career for the great career that it was, and go out there and enjoy the next chapter. Thanks, Bridget, for everything that you've done for Target. Best of luck to you.
So in 2008, I had the chance to join the Six Sigma team that Bridget Evans was leading, and I was excited to learn Six Sigma, but even more excited to be able to work for Bridget, as she was just a legend. And what I really learned from Bridget was one, persistence. Bridget is just phenomenal, being focused every day and just being such a professional every day with how she leads herself and her team. She also took someone in me who had zero PowerPoint skills, really, and really showed me the way to communicate and to really drive programs and be a project manager, and it's just been a huge learning for me that I've used every day. Bridget, I even used Minitab just last week, so the statistical side of the Six Sigma staying with me over these past 6-7 years. And, and I'll always miss being able to talk Minnesota Twins baseball with Bridget. That was really, really fun. Just one of the best times of Target to be able to work with someone as great as Bridget. So Bridget, congratulations on your retirement. You will be missed, and I wish you all the best of luck.
Legend has it that in the company's bylaws, a provision was made for a helicopter to land on the roof at headquarters in case of a fire, in order to take away the most crucially important team members to keep the business operating effectively. According to that legend, Bridget Evans was designated as employee number 3 on that helicopter because she knows absolutely everything about inventory management. Bridget, I know you've always cringed at me calling you the Bridget of Oz, but I can't help it. You do know everything about inventory management, and I've really appreciated everything you've brought to Target and to me personally over my career, most specifically when I was leading MPOps. So I really appreciate everything you've done. Congratulations on your retirement, and all my best to you as you get a chance to cycle more, garden more, go to baseball games more, and do all the things you want to do. So congratulations, thank you for everything, and all my best.
The thing I'll remember most about Bridget is her ability to respectfully criticize ideas, some of which have, I'm sure, been extraordinarily bad, and some of which probably came from me over the time, but with the amount of knowledge that
she has on the systems and knowing how bad some of those are, it never came across in a disrespectful way, which is obviously great for the organization, but it is also a true testament to the character that she has, and I think part of the reason why she was well loved and will be missed. So Bridget, best of luck in your retirement. Have fun just living life and enjoy.
Hi, as I'm sitting here thinking about what I wanted to say as we say farewell to Bridget today, I just wanted to thank her just for answering my numerous questions. Over 75% of them were dumb questions, but she always made me feel like I at least had the right thought process, even if it was completely wrong. So I will miss that about Bridget, just the knowledge that she had and how she looked at us as peers and equals, even though she was head and shoulders above every single one of us. So I will miss that about Bridget. One of my favorite stories actually just happened a couple weeks ago. We were in business update. A couple partners on my team were giving the presentation, and I was there just to support. And they're giving a presentation on a process that they were going to do, and the question was brought up on how some system would work with this process. And everyone's looking around the room. Nobody really has the right answer. And I think Graves finally chimes up and says it's probably on the process page or the wiki or something like that. You know, so that gets Bridget's ears perked up. And the one thing I'll take away from this is Bridget taught me job security in this meeting. And she sat back after Graves said that and said, you know what, guys? I made a whole career out of answering questions that people could just look up for themselves. So I'll always take that back, that that if it works for Bridget Evans, it'll work for me.
Bridget, I want to wish you a wonderful retirement. I'm so happy for you. You're going to be able to spend a lot of time with friends and family. I hope you get to travel a lot, see the world, do all the things that you didn't have time for before. And most of all, I hope you stay healthy and that your brain stays as sharp as it has been for the last 15 plus years here at Target. I'm going to miss seeing my team do the victory dance, or like a leap of joy when they get a question in from Bridget Evans and they actually are able to answer it, and the smile on their face when like, I was able to help Bridget. Or the one thing that I'm not gonna miss is probably dealing with week 53 with you. I'm gonna miss you. But I hope you're not gonna miss dealing with that. Week 53 is gonna be fun this year, and you probably couldn't have picked a better year for you to retire. Not so good for us, but very good for you. So, see the world, enjoy friends, enjoy retirement. I am very blessed to have been able to work with you, and I hope I get to run into you again in the future. Thank you very much. Bye, Bridget.
Hey, Bridget, this is Bob. Hey, couple things that I wanted to cover with you or talk to you about. You know, one is just recently I asked you a question. So what are you going to do on those first, you know, few days or weeks or whatever of retirement? And one of the things you said was, I'm going to work at sleeping in till the sun comes up, those kind of things. And, you know, sort of dawned on me today, I think you've already been doing that. So one thing I could always count on is when I came into the parking garage, and it was always, you know, 6:15, 6:30 or whatever, much more often than not, your car was already there, something you could always count on. But you know what I've realized is over the past, I don't know, month and a half or so, not so much the case. So no judgment, just saying, I think you're already working on sleeping in. Other thing, and much more important, I guess, is, you know, you have touched the hearts and lives of so many people here at Target, and I'm so lucky to to be one of those, and I thank you for that. It's pretty cool when you sit back, and I sort of sat back and thought about all the cool things that we've worked together on, and it's just been a blast. IWs and top items, grid pick, high velocity, rapid rep, the AT Kearney segmentation work, replenishment training, and throughout all of those, just countless hours of talk and discussion and debate around replenishment and ideas and what about this, what about that. It's times that I'll never forget. The fondest memories of Target. You're right there in them. So thank you. And it's not goodbye. It's best wishes until we meet again. Happy trails, Bridget.
Hi, Bridget. Congratulations. 35 years at Target is an amazing accomplishment, and you've had a legendary career that will live on well beyond your time here with everything you've accomplished. Really wanted to personally thank you for everything you've done to help me, whether it was early on in my career, helping roll out new GMS systems, or most recently working together in merchandise planning operations. You've taught me so much, too many to mention, around understanding replenishment, how to do things the right way, but most importantly, what I've appreciated and what I've learned from you have really been around your patience. Whenever I ask the same questions over, always being willing to answer them, but also whenever the phrase check with Bridget or have you talked to Bridget has come up, you're always willing to jump in and help us answer the same questions, I'm sure, multiple different times. I've also learned your passion and conviction to fix things the right way and make sure we understand root cause versus at times wanting to take the easy way out. And last but not least, but most importantly, your commitment to ensuring merchandise planning and the supply chain are here to serve our guests and that we always remember that in everything that we do. I'd be lying if I didn't say I was a little bit nervous about not being able to ask you those questions, but with the work you've done on knowledge management, as I mentioned, your legacy will live on and we'll have a tremendous amount of documentation to refer back to, but just in case, you may find this phone somewhere in your house, and if it rings, please pick up because it's me and I need your help. So congratulations, best wishes again, and I hope you enjoy everything that retirement has to offer, and please keep in touch.
Hey, Bridget! Thanks for inventing air!
Hi, Bridget. On behalf of the forecast and SWAT team, we want to congratulate you on your retirement. And in celebration of that, we put together a top six Bridget learnings list. It was going to be a top 10, but 7 through 10 got truncated.
So starting off with number 6, always order the steak. When it comes to system enhancement requests, if you order the steak, you might get a hot dog. If you start by ordering the hot dog, you'd probably just get the bun.
Number 5, the value of not rolling my eyes the 20th time I've answered the same question.
Number 4, yes, Bridget, I did save this list on the kick.
Number 3, the value of not rolling my eyes the 20th time I've got the same question.
Number 6.1.2, if you save all your documents in paper form, you don't have to worry about the land drive cleanup.
And number 1, seriously, limiting it to just top 10 wasn't possible. That would only cover last week.
Thank you, Bridget.
Hey, Bridget, congrats and good luck on your retirement. Thought I'd share with you some of the favorite things that I've learned from you over the course of the years that we've worked together, whether that was when I was an intern up here or most recently as SGMs together. I think the one thing that I've learned most and will always remember is to never forget Rapid Rep in the UDC. I just want you to know we will always think of that and make sure we plan a really great strategy with you in mind. But secondly, I think the biggest thing you've taught us is to just always ask questions, really think about the guests, and never settle for averages. Just some good things to think through as we get moving pretty quickly and want to make the right decisions. You've just really helped us focus on those outliers and never forget your store. Or you as the guest. So just want you to know we will always remember you and your many words of wisdom that have helped us succeed so far. So thanks again and good luck.
Hey, Bridget. I think the biggest things that I learned from you are the importance of knowledge management and knowledge transfer. And I also learned how insanely difficult both of those things are. So seriously, I've learned a ton over the years. Thank you for everything and happy retirement.
Not so fast! Not so fast! I'll have to give the matter a little thought. Go away and come back tomorrow.
Toto? I have a feeling we're not in Kansas anymore.
Ow! Go.
47 years ago, Bridget created the RE team. And we want to thank her for all of the contributions that she has made to us. And today we'd like to thank her for just some of the things that she's helped us with.
The first thing is answering questions when MPSD is stumped or closes the ticket. Helping us understand special OTL.
And M&M logic.
Training all the new replenishment experts and being patient through all of our aha moments. Showing the A&A team how to turn off assortment item default so we stop sending whole chain assortments to one store.
Knowing every post report to ever exist and what it means.
Saving every important paper document that's ever existed at Target.
And also staying on call for week 53 after retirement.
So thanks, Bridget.
Thank you.
I was on Bridget's team for 7 years, so I can't just give one thing I learned. I'll give three. Number one, know your resources. You don't have to have all the answers, although Bridget probably does. You just need to know who to ask. Number two, be curious, dig in, figure out how it works. Sometimes the smallest thing makes the biggest difference. Number three, don't forget to have fun. Sometimes it's the little things, like make your own peanut butter and jelly sandwiches at back to school time. Those little things make a big difference. Thank you, Bridget, for all your hard work. You made an impact on my career and countless others. We used to joke about how you were so critical you had your own escape pod. We will all miss you.
Hey, Bridget, congratulations on your retirement. The big day is finally here. I wish you all the best in your future, and I want to take a minute to thank you for everything that you've done for me personally here at Target. It has been an honor to work with you over the past 20 years. On the replenishment team, the Six Sigma team, and most recently, the knowledge management team. Thank you for all your patience and all your explaining of replenishment. You have truly been an awesome leader, and you will be missed. Good luck in your future, and be sure to come back and visit. Bye-bye.
Cool. Hi, Bridget.
Hi, Bridget.
Hey, Bridget.
We just want to say happy retirement and run through what we've learned from you.
We did a lot.
I mean, a lot of things, obviously, but we're going to try and run through it succinctly.
Yeah, so we boiled it down to four things that we learned, just the four most important. Number one, value of the presale. If you have a great idea, complex idea, always get Bridget on board. You're always going to get success from that.
Her not in a meeting is more important than other people understanding anything about what you're saying.
It's probably the only thing that matters.
Mm-hmm. Number two, document all the things. When we met with the interim guy, he said, Bridget's retiring? Ugh.
Ooh.
You're screwed, Target. Hope she's written everything down. So we want to make sure that we have all of our knowledge written down so that we can pass it off.
I still have all of the segment OTL work at my desk still 5 years later because you told me to save it at all costs.
The third thing is have a sense of humor when dealing with system things. System things can be complicated and tiresome and really complex. When we were first building the odd OTL policing system, which is fondly known as OOPS, it was tough sometimes to deal with all the logic, but then I remembered, hey, like, you named it OOPS. So I come to find out that you're the one with a sense of humor and named it OOPS. So when time came to potentially change the name to like Oopsie Doopsie or like like Supply Chain Block, we're like, no, like we have to keep OOPS because it was so awesome and it was a great decision and a great decision by you.
And then the last one is Brandon to share your knowledge. So. Kind of a learning, but also what I appreciated most, Bridget, about you is no matter how hard the challenges that we brought to you with questions, or how easy you always took the time out to share your knowledge about it. So from the first time of me being an RE, where you had to walk through front loading, which had to be at least the 10,000th time, you still took 30 minutes to walk through it with me. Or, you know, years later when we worked through system logic together and you had to talk through the time of when different systems actually batched, you took the time on those complex issues. So sharing your knowledge is something that I'll take, regardless of the complexity, in roles to come.
Thank you for making us all better. We'll miss you.
She Bridget.
Happy retirement.
Congratulations.
Hi, Bridget. Congratulations on your retirement. It's been great working with you over the many years, and thank you for all your patience and time and knowledge sharing as we've worked together on the supply chain systems here at Target. I'm expecting that you will enjoy your time off, and I will be here working on fixing PBI truncation. Anyways, have a great retirement. Congratulations again. Thank you.
Bridget, thanks so much for all your contributions to Target through the years. So best of luck on your retirement.
Hi, Bridget. Happy retirement. We were asked to share some of our favorite stories about you and how we remember you at Target. And so as I was thinking back into when I first started hearing your name and started to get to know you, it actually goes back to when I was in manager training. And I believe at the time you were teaching some sort of a financial planning class. And I vividly remember you coming in to teach. And you had been the manager of Department 80, which was the new department that I was a manager of. And all I remember in my mind thinking was, I'm going to screw this up because Bridget Evans was the manager. And she clearly is much smarter than I am. And so that was all I could think of the rest of the training. But I think just a clear sign of how respected you are and how much weight you carry and your name carries with everybody here at Target. So you are going to be terribly missed. You've obviously been a huge part of my career throughout the time I've been here, whether working together or just knowing, you know, anytime somebody has a question, many times the answer is, well, if you ask Bridget, Bridget Evans will know. And so really just thank you for everything that you've done for us in your time here at Target, and good luck. Congratulations. What an amazing accomplishment for you, and really wish you well as you're able to now take a step back and not have to think about AIR and all the different PresMin logic and OTLs and all the questions we ask you. We might be calling you from time to time, but you know, Bridget Evans legacy will live on. So congratulations and thank you for everything you did.
Bridget, congratulations on your retirement. It was great working with you in MP Operations. I really thank you for all of our time together and all of your guidance. I think one of the things working in the role that we have had in MP Operations was interesting because we got a lot of panicked emails, be it from stores or from leadership. And the thing that I appreciate and learned a lot from you was staying calm in those situations and then just dissecting the information and finding out
the logical reason why things happened, and then being able to craft a level-headed and logical response. I also really appreciate all the great nuggets of information and historical facts that you had around our systems and how things worked, and just being able to tie back all that logic to some great solutions and great process improvements. And personally, it was wonderful to be able to work with you, Bridget, and just stay connected over all these years. Congratulations again on your retirement, and best of luck.
Bridget, so congratulations on your retirement. Very excited for you. One of the things that I wanted to do was put together this really big, long presentation on all the different things that you've done as far as being a mentor and leader for me at Target. But in one of the lessons that I remember you saying, particularly from Rick, saying, just get to the content, get right to it. Don't worry about some of the fluff around that. I'm just going to get right to it. So, to the point, a couple of points I want to talk about are things I've learned from you. Paper's valuable. I think one of the things that we've learned as far as, you know, getting rid of different drives and things like that is always going back to your drawers and saying, this is what we've done before, or have you looked at this yet, and how important that is. And I think that's something I'll continue to remember. Second point, history repeats itself. I think sometimes the way you went about actually working with teams that have done things over and over and over, and your attitude and the way you went about that was a great example for a lot of us at Target. And so I just think that as things continue to come up, that I'll be able to like take that attitude lesson from you and really try to own that going forward. And that kind of leads into assume positive intent. I think in a lot of the ways that I saw you interact with others, you always had this way of just assuming that people are trying to do the right thing, that they're not trying to, you know, do really negative things. And I think that's really helped you in getting a lot of work done in a great way. And so that's something I'm going to want to do. The next line, history repeats itself. I think you can hopefully appreciate that. The next one, connect the dots. I think even though you maybe weren't officially Six Sigma certified, I think you did a fabulous job at problem solving and really trying to ask great questions and pull things together in ways that I've really tried to leverage throughout my career and hope to continue to do that. So I just want to, again, thank you for that lesson, as well as history repeating itself, because you know that it does. And then play nice. It's funny, when I was thinking about different things that, you know, have been said about you in particular, you know, I've even asked a couple folks, have you ever heard of anyone say, you know, a bad thing about Bridget? And everyone said, no, she's the sweetest person in the world. And I think that legacy is just something for you to be really proud of, and you know, I think it's something that I can try to learn as well. So I just wanted to say congratulations on your retirement. It's very well deserved, and stay in touch.
Gangsta of MPOps. Thank you for helping us ramp into the new FCs this last year by hand writing out IPS calculation on an 8x11 sheet of paper.
The biggest lesson that Bridget Evans has taught me is that while not all problems, questions, or issues are created equally, you can still be nice in answering them. It might take her another 34 years, though, to teach me to be nice.
Bridget, congratulations. It seems like just 10 years ago, which I guess it was 10 years ago, that a young SBA came and interviewed with you, and you asked your signature question of walking through the in-stock troubleshooting flowchart. It must have done okay, because three rounds of MPOps and on and off, 10 years of working together, has gone by fast. Thank you for everything you taught me, and enjoy your retirement.
Closing time, open all the doors and let you out into the world. Closing time, turn all of the lights on over every boy and every girl. Closing time, one last call for alcohol, so finish your whiskey.